Extremes. This comes from the next chapter, sacred and profane extremes, right? This guy on the left, Galileo, liberated physics from theology. You know this? He did. What happened to him? Banned by the sacred extremists. Okay? Banned. He was put under threat of death for doing this. Okay? Hobbes liberated politics from theology. That's why we have, in theory, a separation of church from state. I know some people don't get this, okay? Especially even in the White House, but we do have a mandate for separating church from state, and that was largely due to the Leviathan of Hobbes. What happened to him? Banned by sacred extremists, okay? Sacred extremists. Darwin liberated biology from theology. You already know what happened to him, right? Banned by sacred. And still in Tennessee, he's banned by sacred extreme. We're still fighting that fight, are we not? 70 years after the Scopes trial, they've still outlawed the teaching of evolutionary theory in many schools in the Bible Belt. Sacred extremists, they'll ban it. If they don't like it, they'll ban it. If it's not in their book, they'll ban it, okay? That's not good. Then at the other extreme, it's not good either. The other extreme is the profane extremes, okay? See, Einstein, you know, Einstein, what happened to him? Jewish physics. Yeah, right, Jewish physics, right? Like, the laws of nature are, you know, what color? You know, give me a break, okay? Banned by the Nazis, Jewish physics. It's true, it's true. Heisenberg was threatened with dismissal. He mentioned Einstein's name in a lecture once, and he was threatened. The only reason his job was saved, his sister was a friend of Himmler's, okay? So they gave him a break, they cut him some slack. Jewish physics, sure. This guy, Gregor Mendel, you know, inadvertently confirmed he didn't know about Darwin's work, but he did these feedback genetics. You know this, okay? So he did this stuff and banned, selective genetics banned by the Stalinists. And I'm explaining all of this in here. Why did they ban selective genetics? Because they had to follow Lysenko. Selective genetics were politically incorrect. The Stalinists had to ban Darwin because of social Darwinism. That wasn't Darwin's fault. Darwin wouldn't endorse Marx's work. But everybody said, oh, you know, social Darwinism is obviously a bad thing, so Darwin must be a bad thing. So they threw out the baby of Darwin with the bathwater of social Darwinism. They ended up starving millions of people in Ukraine because they banned selective genetics. Last one. Can you see this? 1 + 1. What's 1 + 1? Any volunteers? Nobody's. Now you're all afraid, right? Okay, it's a loaded question. Now you've figured it. Every question here is loaded. How much is 1 + 1? Nobody wants to say. We have a brave volunteer. 2. You're banned. You think 1 + 1 is 2, ma'am? I'm sorry to say you are banned. Okay, by order of the profane extremes of truth and reality are banned by postmodernism. There is no truth and no reality. Never mind that 1 + 1, you know, is provable to be true, and everything works that works because the subways run because 1 + 1 is 2. Your cell phone works because 1 + 1 is 2, the videography and the photography and everything else under the sun works because 1 + 1 is 2. Why is it banned? And if it's banned, what is 1 + 1 equal to? That's easy. 1 + 1 equals smiley face. Whatever makes you feel good, folks. Whatever everybody plays, everybody wins. You know, that's why our students are now losing ground severely, because our education system's been deconstructed. There's no truth and no reality left in it. I'm in the front lines. It's not a joke. 1 + 1 is whatever makes you feel good. But on top of that, and you're 1 + 1, you must never say that 1 + 1 is equal to anything that might offend somebody, God forbid. So if you belong to a religion in which 1 + 1 is 3, you know, and I can't say 1 + 1 is 2 because I don't want to offend you. Excuse me, am I responsible for your state of mind? Not according to the ABCs. According to political correctness, everyone's responsible for everybody else's state of mind, but not their own. Right? Orwell would be freaking out. If Orwell could come back and see this, he'd say, I didn't go far enough. This is much crazier than anything Orwell ever imagined. And that's the truth.